16, 6:30 in the morning. I'm giving a hey. So, listen, I got over 350 emails with people wanting to get in the basket. So don't worry. I can't do it. I'm good till January. But I'm going to sit down and I'm going to, type out everybody's name and make the little things. I'll just sit down and go through each one. So, whoa, that was a shock. It was like, you have 350. So anyway, what else do I want to tell you? I'm getting a cold. My nose just started running. So I got my Kleenex. I just took some Alka-Seltzer and my nose is just running. I don't feel sick. I have to go into Angel today and then supposed to help my son tomorrow. He got his own little bachelor pad. So mom is gonna get him a bed. So he needs a good bed, so that's what we're gonna go shopping tomorrow. Okay, so, all right, you guys, are you ready? Is it exciting or what? Listen, I got a couple of flashes I wanna tell you. First of all, I keep seeing Barr, okay? And Barr is like, talking to Trump, and he's feeling like he's got to cut him loose or there's something. In fact, Barr might even step down because I'm feeling Trump is desperate and he's really screaming. People are staying away from him. But can I just look real quick? I just want to take a quick, I know we read on him all the time, but I'm feeling Barr doesn't have the goods. And so, you know what I'm saying? It's, hello. And Barr's feeling like Trump is out of control, especially with that thing that he did with talking trash about the ambassador. That was perfect. He couldn't have done anything more perfect. And it's like the Republicans are spinning. I do see Jim Jordan and Devin Nunes, but I see people standing down, people walking away like, we don't know you. Even McConnell's like, dude, what are you doing? But I do see Barr telling Trump the truth and saying, you're blowing it. Alka-Seltzer. Okay, now, I just want to take a quick look-see. And I got my new deck that I saw with Revealing Light. I love her decks. So I've been, playing with this one. I sleep on my cards. Accidentally found a half a cookie. I don't know where that came from, but it was in my bed next to my cards. So I think the angels were bringing me cookies. Okay, so tell me what I can tell everybody about Barr. What can I tell everybody? Barr is, I just felt them. And here's the other thing I got too. I got that Kushner. Remember I told you? Kushner is, he's in trouble. That's what I'm getting, and he knows it. And Ivanka's in trouble. So what you call's hitting the fans. And also, Stone got hit with 7 counts. And it's funny, because just that morning I said guilty, but I'm going to find my previous from last year. I believe I was even talking with Third Eye Champagne, and we were sitting there. We saw Stone going down. So this was like 2 years ago, but he was so pompous and he was getting away with everything, but we saw Stone going down. So we predicted that like 2 years ago. I did an extra one by myself, and I remember talking with Kirsten, and we both were like, oh yeah, you know how Kirsten lives. This MF is going down. But his cards weren't good. And Barr's cars aren't good, but I just feel like he's under too much pressure. I even see his wife saying, get out. Get out before the ship sinks. Okay, so Barr, he's very disappointed. This is worse than he thought. You know, the Trump thing was tough. But Barr is, I'm gonna tell you, he's packing his seven of swords. He's packing his bags. You know, he comes off like an emperor. He really thinks he knows everything. And he's crossed by the five of cups. So disappointment, he's packing his stuff. He's res to go, okay? He has enough money, so he doesn't have to worry about money. And here's Trump. Trump's in front of him. Hello, everybody. Ding dong, death, it's over. Either that or he drops dead. He's dealing with Satan. So Trump, the two cards after Trump was death and Satan. So I just think Trump is losing it. We're gonna have to take a quick look. See, I know I read on him yesterday. So Barr can't keep them away anymore. He's got the Nine of Wands reversed as the outcome. So I just feel like he energetically can't keep things going. He just can't seem to get Trump under control. He's a gangster. He's no good. So, whoops. So there's a woman here. This is Pelosi. Pelosi. So Pelosi's coming forward with something too. Something secret will be revealed. And the Ten of Cups is next to it. So, but listen, when I was, you know, when I drive home, I have to drive quite a ways. And I'm energetically thinking, and I just see, because his people love him, and that's who they are. They can't help it. They love him, and they want him to be okay. I had a client yesterday that was telling me that her friend, who's wealthy, is saying, if Trump doesn't get reelected, we're going to go into a tailspin. Well, you know what? We're in the worst depression as far as overextending than we ever have. We'll look at the monetary issues, but it's like a fake, you know, like we did before the 2008. Remember, it's not going to be as bad, and we're going to readjust, but it's not going to be Armageddon. That I can tell you. Okay, now, poor farmers are committing suicide. It's terrible. Okay, so, just out of curiosity, because I'm here. Just out of curiosity, I got to look at... Tell me what I can tell everybody. I have to just look at Trump. What's going on with you? Because he blew it. Let me tell you, I saw people like telling him, what are you doing? The thing is with him, you can't tell him too much. And when he's real grouchy, real weird, you can't deal with him. But I feel like they're like, sir, you know, I see somebody, you know, Miller doesn't tell him off. Miller Hyde. Stephen Miller, we're going to look at him too. Stephen Miller's going down. I think I talked to you guys before. I got to look at my old videos and give you guys the 411 and lay out what I said. Okay, so. What are you thinking now, Trump? What's going on with you? Look around you. He's talking about having to leave. I see him talking to his family. He can't talk to Melania. She's almost treating it like, good, good, we can get out of here. And I can divorce you and have my own life. What's gonna happen? Tell me what's gonna happen. Tell me what's gonna happen. Okay. So. Okay, here he is. This is him. Well, he's got the demon. That's who he is. This Trump is the demon now. He's in such a funk. He's like maybe calling witches and asking him to help him. This woman's coming after him. This woman's coming after him. He really is feeling lost. Money is reversed. He wants to like hide. He doesn't want to be out there. Maybe he'll keep his mouth shut for a while. His fortunes are changing. His fortune's fate, in the famous words of Shakespeare. So he's finding solace in the family. I don't know what his kids are saying to him, but he's finding solace in the family and close friends, like the Fox News friends. But I feel like he has to hamper down, not, you know, like I think he realizes, even though he doesn't care, you know, talking trash about her was just, oh my God, wasn't that amazing, you guys? Adam Schiff, listen, I got to tell you, I had a hit on her too. Ambassador, the one who testified yesterday, I saw them doing a movie on her. I saw her doing her story, and they talk about what happened with this. By the way, I was at the movies the other day. There's a movie coming up on that Gretchen gal from Fox News. Nicole Kidman's in it. All kinds of famous people are in it. Oh, it looks good. Yeah, it's about that pig that ran Fox News. Oh my God, it looks good. So anyway, Nicole, you know, she's an Academy Award winning actress. She's very tall, she's blonde. She's the one that played the lesbian that murdered men. You know who I'm talking about? She's so gorgeous. She's playing that tall, the one that Trump said was bleeding out her eyes. So, oh yeah, this looks good. I can't wait, you guys. Well, hey, y'all come out. We'll all go see it together. 350 people show up. Well, actually, I got 26,000 subscribers, who I love. Okay, you guys, so I saw them, like, talking to her already. I mean, they might help her write a book, and then they make it into a movie. But I saw them make a movie about her. So I just flashed. Boom. Okay, so Trump is going down, but he's finding solace. So he's energetically, you know, he's in his head a lot, and he always thinks he's right. So in a way, he's just sitting with the people that are stroking him and telling him everything's going to be okay. He really is, you know, I'm not going to watch these trials. And then, you know, first saying, oh, who is this ambassador? She's no good. You know. Okay, so instead of helping his case or frightening people, I see more people coming forward. I see people saying, F you, dude. What do you think about that guy that listened to the phone conversation? Someone else will come out and say they heard that too. So on that note, we need to look at next week Ambassador Sondland, the one who made the phone call. The one who suddenly remembered, oh yeah, that's right. He did say it was quid pro whatever. It was bribe. Yeah, it was bribery. Yeah, now I remember. And they'll get his records from his phone. And an unsecured phone, but lock her up, you know? Unsecured phone, but lock her up. So this is going to be so much fun, you guys. I am so, you know, they were saying it's a nothing burger. We'll see what the Senate's going to do with it, but I almost feel like I saw this McConnell try to shake it, but it comes back because I see sane people tell him, dude, this is a little too much to just throw it away and say this is a nothing burger. We're going to have to listen to the evidence. We're going to have to bring it to trial. That's what I saw. And the other thing I saw was John Roberts doing this. Like, almost like it's overwhelming, the stuff he has to look at, and it's so ugly that it makes him sick, because this guy is such a fraud. Anyway, Ambassador Sondland. Ambassador Sondland, tell me about him. Next week he's testifying. What say you? Sondland has an attorney. Sondland, he actually is distancing himself from Trump, and I almost feel Trump or his sidekick, Trump isn't trying to get a hold of him, but he's got people trying to talk to him. But everybody's being really careful because everybody can go to jail. So I see his attorney saying, disconnect, dude, you can't. I bet Trump wishes he didn't take that $1 million. Tell me about next week. How can he plead the fifth? Can he plead the fifth? But this isn't a criminal trial, so he can't plead the fifth. I wonder if something else is coming up where he pleads the fifth. I don't know why I heard that, okay? Sonderland. See, Sonderland's worried about his own ass, too. And he's worried he'll go to jail because of Trump, because he lied to Congress. Blatantly lied to Congress. Someone else is coming out about that phone call. They heard it. People are pissed. They don't care. They're coming out. All of a sudden, you're going to see like droves of people. Who's that woman that keeps yapping and due to a Schiff we have, and he's telling her, you're not acknowledged. They're acting all push out of shape. They really look bad, you guys. The Republicans look really bad. Sonderland has an attorney. Sonderland is thinking of getting out of Dodge. He's struggling. He's got the Ten of Swords in his house. He's got the Ten of Swords. So it's interesting because in the Ten of Pentacles and the Hopes, Dreams, and Wishes reverse. So he's worried about losing money. He's worried about how he looks. The outcome is justice. Justice, I dare say. See what a scourge is laid upon your hate. Yep, justice. So he's got no choice in this matter. He's going to have to throw Trump under the bus. Judgment. Oh, these cards are talking. Ooh, yeah. He'll get out by the skin. It's just like he gets out by a hair's breadth. He's going to be okay because he turns state's witness or whatever they call it. He's going to turn into a witness, but he saved his ass just a wee bit. Just a wee bit. So, okay. But he's going to, ooh, justice is here. So he has more to say. Okay. Trump can't get to him, but he wants to get to him. They'll call him a liar, too. Okay, so I got Ambassador. I got Trump. Who else did I do? Barr. And there was one other thing. I want to look at Stone and see if Trump is actually going to. They're telling him he took the bullet for Trump. He took the bullet for Trump, but such a pompous ass. He wanted to be the king for a day. It was all like, yeah, I got the info. I'm the main man. I see him and I see him telling people, yeah, Trump, he'll get me out of this. So let's see. I don't see Trump even attempting right now. And if anything, I do see Barr telling him, don't be, you know, forgiving these people or getting them out because you already look really bad. This is going to amplify it. Okay, so tell me what happened with Stone. Did he write that? I don't know. I haven't looked at Trump's. Did he text about what happened to Stone? Because it was a jury trial, so don't say, oh, it was unfair. It was a jury trial. Okay, so we'll. Trump give him reprieve. Will Trump say, you're forgiven? See, Trump thinks he's king, so in a way, he almost likes, don't question me. But Trump's not talking to Stone, which worries Stone. But he's also like saying, well, he's not talking to me because he's got to keep it under the down low. Okay, so it starts off with a chariot reverse. I think he wants to do it. Here's the king, Trump. He wants to do it, but he's looking at ways to do it for him. He's looking at ways to do it for him. If the hermit, remember I told you he's on the down low. He's starting to step back. He's not there's communications going on, like they're trying to talk to him. But here's the thing. Trump can't... not Trump. What's his name? Stone. And I heard this on MSNBC, and I totally agree. I don't know about you guys, but I feel like they're saying, you know, we don't care what you say because you're such a liar. We wouldn't be able to trust you like Manafort. So there's nothing he can turn Trump in for. Ooh, all of them have the demon, you guys. All of them. So it's ugly. Old Stone's going to jail. Seven. I wonder if it's 7 years. Somebody had said seven, but he was indicted on 7 counts. Here's his wife. She's going to get sick from this. And he's worried about money, too. So money is a problem. I don't know why Giuliani just got in my head. He's running, too. Okay, so, yeah, Stone, it doesn't look good, and I don't see a reprieve at this point. I think Trump's going to have to go and doesn't have the opportunity to get out Manafort and Stone. That's what I'm getting. Okay, now, a lot of you want to know about the white supremacist. Sorry, Stephen Miller. Okay? He's a creep. He's creepy. I know he's Jewish, but he had a family member talk about him that, you know, he doesn't stand by the Jewish people. He turned out to be a bad seed. So he's got this power with Trump, and he's just devastating communities, people, locking up children, giving Trump the permission. Well, Trump doesn't care. He does what he wants. He doesn't care. We'll talk about these children the next time because remember I said it's going to take a while, but they will gather up. And I see lawsuits against the United States for what happened to these kids. Children are missing and dead. Okay, so Stephen Miller, what's the deal? Stephen Miller. He's losing his... When I see the Five of Pentacles reversed and the Hangman crossing it, this is me. Remember, I do my interpretations different. I never went to anything formal. He's losing his energy, his powers, his ability to create money. He's almost like... Remember, Sarah Sanders is complaining that nobody wants to hire her because she worked for Trump? That's that energy I'm getting. He's like, people are going, ew, get away from me. He has the Three of Cups which is that wedding. I don't know why this woman wants to marry him. I actually see him having a child. he's going to get in trouble too, you guys. I see a child. I wonder if she's going to get pregnant right away because I see a child and I see him getting in a lot of trouble and I see him walking away. I see him being put in jail. She actually loves him. Oh my God. Well, you can't beat love. A pair of star-crossed lovers. So she might end up raising this kid on her own. It just feels like he's really in a lot of trouble and he's going to be really wishing woe in the day that he hurt other human beings. He will pay in this lifetime. And energetically, that card can even mean jail. So, okay. But he's in the battlefield. He'll be battling he can't turn anybody in because it was his idea. Now, a lot of you guys wrote me and asked about Deval Patrick. Somebody said Obama encouraged him to run. He's running for president. Tell me about Deval Patrick. And I don't feel Hillary Clinton throwing her hat in. Maybe I'm wrong. Because I used to think Hillary Clinton was going to win as president. Maybe she will win. Well, she did win. But, you know, maybe she throws her hat in and takes it because I was shocked when Trump won. And I think it was taken from us. I think the Russians helped him win. This wasn't Although a lot of people were, because of the bullshit stories they were telling about Hillary. Okay, Deval Patrick. But her emails. Can you believe she didn't use the secured line? Trump was over there, you know, corrupt. And here's his family's doing it. Tell me what your chances are of winning as president of the United States. I did not see Bloomberg, sorry. Somebody told me that Bloomberg was the one that did the stop and frisk, that you could stop and frisk anybody. And they were hitting up blacks and Mexicans. Yeah, no, that's not cool. Well, Patrick. And I felt the youth and women coming forward. So nobody wants a billionaire, really. They're like, we don't want this. We're tired of the money, the alleged money people. Deval Patrick, Knight of Pentacles, Ten of Cups. So he's happily married. His wife is pretty powerful. She's a nice person. I wonder if she's close friends with Michelle. His fortune, he's got the Wheel of Fortune. And his house is the Four of Wands, which tells me he's in a happy house. His wife is running the show. His wife is the pretty spectacular. Will he win? It's saying, oh, karmically, he has something to do in this world. So he has the Star, but he's got the Emperor reverse, which means he doesn't take the baton. But maybe he has something to do in the national course of things. He's a potential that could even be president, you know, maybe not this time, but down the road. But he doesn't gather up enough steam, I heard. And I'll have to go on his website and view and take a look at what he believes in and stuff, where he stands. I'm not even going to bother with Bloomberg. I could care less. Sorry. There's just something about it that just doesn't set with me. Okay, all right, you guys. Oh, listen, somebody wrote me and needed to cancel. I think it was a February appointment. And I'll be doggone, I can't find her email anywhere. And I want to give her a refund, but I've got to have her name so I can find her on PayPal and refund her. So could you please write me again and say, hi, I'm the one that needs to cancel. I think it's February, an appointment in February or something. Because, you know, those appointments get taken like that. So no problem, girlfriend. But just write me again so I can hopefully find you in the flux of people sending me emails. But, yeah, I don't want to not cancel you. It's no problem to cancel. Okay. Namaste. You guys take care. I will talk to you later. Ciao.